the 17th annual NoDQ.com Year-End Awards.
Theme song of the year, and Jeff is upset because he wanted to actually play the songs, but you guys can look them up on YouTube if you need to. If you're not familiar with the songs, then why wouldn't you be? So let's go over the nominees here. The Rising Sun, Shinsuke Nakamura. Glorious Domination, Bobby Roode. Phenomenal, AJ Styles. Catch Your Breath, Finn Balor. Sky's the Limit, Sasha Banks. And Soft is a Sin, Enzo and Cass. Is it bad that for the longest time I was wondering what the hell SAWFT stood for? I was like, SAWFT, what does that mean?
Yeah. Weird.
Took me forever to realize, oh, it's how people on the
Swift.
East Coast pronounce soft.
Swift? Yeah, exactly.
I felt like such an idiot.
Considering you grew up on the East Coast part of your life, come on, Rift, come on.
Yeah, I know,
that's
right?
Terrible. Your mother is ashamed of you right now.
She is.
Terrible. Your dad's looking down like, really? Really?
All right, so what's your pick here?
My pick is a song that I literally, every time I go walk my son to school, and I'm coming back, I got the earbuds in, walking back. It's about a mile walk back from school. I play a country song that nobody's heard of on this channel except...
Blake Shelton?
No, not Blake Shelton. It's called Thinking of You by Chris Young and Cassidy Pope. That's the first song I play.
And then Barbie Girl.
Not Barbie Girl. Oh. That was the old Jeff.
Oh.
The second song I play is Glorious Domination. That song...
Motivates you.
It motivates me to walk harder,
make
walk
your day
faster,
glorious.
Make my day glorious. Exactly. And seeing that display on NXT Brooklyn, where 15,000 people are singing that song. He never hadn't played that song yet on TV, as far as I know.
Yeah.
But they all knew it. And then seeing it live in Bakersfield was unbelievable. I mean, it was a little bitty arena, but it sounded like a 15,000 seat theater where everybody was singing it. Between that song and Nakamura's song, I put the videos on Twitter, probably got in trouble with WWE for it, but I don't care, because the entrances were unbelievable. And Bobby's whole presentation is so well done now that he's in WWE and NXT. So my pick is Glorious Domination for Bobby Roode.
It's a two-way race for me. It's Bobby Roode and Nakamura. I mean, Nakamura's entrance, same thing. 15,000 people singing his song. And singing his song when he's getting beat down by the heel and the crowd wants him to
make
his
comeback. Yeah, that was something about Toronto.
They were
humming
his
song along to motivate him back up. It was like, I've never seen that before.
I know, that was unbelievable.
That was crazy.
And then the whole entrance of the violins and everything.
The violin stuff live is so good. Oh my god.
It's so tough because the minute I heard Nakamura's theme song, I was like, this is going to go over so huge. Same thing with Bobby Roode. First time I heard it, I'm like, this is going to make him. This is going to make him.
Yeah, we've talked about Bobby. When that video went up on YouTube, you texted me and you go, oh my God, dude, this is going to be something.
This is going to be huge. First time I heard it, I mean, I had no doubts.
Yeah.
They nailed it with this theme song.
They did. They really did. They nailed Bobby.
I hate having to pick one.
Yeah.
I really hate it.
I picked both of them, but I went with Bobby because I like that one just a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, I think I'll go with Nakamura, but I think it's going to be really close.
It will be close.
I think fans like Nakamura a little bit better.
It'll probably be the closest race we have this year.
It might be. It might be one of those that's like where I have to keep posting something on Facebook and Twitter saying, help us break the tie.
Break the tie, kids.
So we'll see how it goes. But I'll make my prediction that Nakamura will win, but it'll be very close.